had a chat to Julia, who was on the beach in the California, and asked about an Eastern European husband.
Well, he's a Russian-speaking Armenian, and he was living in a Russian Soviet Union state called Azerbaijan.
Yeah.
And even though he's culturally Armenian, so in the communist bloc, many countries are communized against their will, and many of the residents there just kind of, not voluntarily, but they have to be compulsorily swept along with whatever the state is dictating. Now, when communism collapsed, he was in one of the states that also collapsed, and he was living in a predominantly Muslim state, and there was a lot of ethnic cleansing of people who were either Christians or Jews or Armenians, and he ended up becoming a refugee and being relocated. So he ended up having to come to America in Hollywood as a refugee when he was about 18.
Yeah.
But he then took American citizenship.
Now, here's a question which I'm going to put you in a dilemma now, Julia. If you had the offer of a lot of work and a lot of finance, but it was back in the UK, do you think you'd move back?
Well, you know, if it was, it, possibly, yes. I mean, I right now I'd go where the work is. I mean, I have a child who's really happy in a wonderful little local school. I have a husband who's got his own thriving oriental acupuncture health practicing office in Calabasas in California.
Yeah.
So it would be hard to drag everyone with me. But, you know, if I got a wonderful job offer over there where they wanted me to come and sing and, you know, or talk on a reality show or whatever it was, I would absolutely consider it, especially in the light of the fact that my parents are not getting any younger.
Well, you never know. You just never, ever know. We're looking forward to you coming back home, so to speak.
Thank you.
You're obviously aware that the weather has been absolutely rubbish over the past 8, 9 months at least.
It's awful. I can't bear it. And I feel so guilty that as I'm talking to you, I'm in this sun-drenched beach scene in Southern California with the Malibu waves crashing on the ocean.
Stop it.
We all love our home country. We love England. There's nothing better, we all know. But let's face it, the weather is a bit of a deal-breaking
It is, really, yeah. The 20th of June, Worcester's Huntingdon Hall. 29th of June, Leicester's The Musician. 7th of July, Cheltenham's Tithe Barn. That's sold out. 8th of July, Bristol's The Thunderbolt. More information, all the W's, juliafordham.com. I'm gonna leave you now to your sultry bikini and your sand-swept and whatever you're getting up to on the beach. A beach party, was it?
It was actually my little girls and a softball team, and it was the after party for the Malibu Bluffs softball experience. She plays on the Malibu Nationals, her little 8-year-old team is called, and one of the coaches happens to have a wonderful home right on the Malibu coast, and we got to go there for an after party. And I was just saying to one of the other English mums, it would be very difficult to explain this experience to anyone in England because both of us marvel because all the other kids come from California, they're second generation.
Yeah.
And for us, we continue to be in awe of this outdoor life, the incredible weather. I mean, it's very seductive. And, I think my child is having a heck of a start. But then, you know, I had a heck of a start in England, and so no regrets. Life just forces its path, doesn't it? And
absolutely,
it goes on the
line,
yeah. And it's going.
Absolutely. Well, you enjoy it while you can, and we'll enjoy you coming over here in the month of June and July. JuliaFordham.com is where you can find all the details. Julia, many thanks.
Thank you so much.
Your positive thinking. I'm happy here with my heart sinking, sitting with the jaded blues. Tons of clouds just follow you. I'm on complete conundrum, dragging to the beat of my drum.
Lady.
Chilled out now, so I am.
I wish I was on Malibu Beach with her.